attempting to fly while carrying all that heavy body armor, he's gonna need some serious power. So how does a rhinoceros beetle keep its huge body airborne? It has a special technique, flying very differently to most birds. Slowed down, you can see that he twists his wing at the base. We need a special flight laboratory to see how this helps. Now, we can see just how the air moves around the beetle's wing. Those mini tornadoes spinning off the wing show where the beetle is pushing the air back, thrusting him forwards. And because it's being pushed down, we know he's also producing lift and thrust to push him forward. So far, that's much like a bird. But by twisting his wings at the base, he can also push air backwards on the upstroke. And there's the proof. This gives him a little bit of extra thrust, and that's something that most birds can't do. But he doesn't leave it there. Even his armored wing cases are working in his favor, forcing air down to create even more lift. So he effectively has an extra pair of wings. This magnificent beetle is a flying marvel. His wings give him the extra lift and thrust that he needs to cruise at 9 miles an hour. He's hardly speedy, nor is he a long-distance flyer, but he can cover half a mile in a night. And in a jungle, that's enough to find a female. This huge beetle's flying mission may have seemed impossible, but it's worth the effort. Special wings that rotate at the base allow the beetle to get more from the air around him, keeping him airborne, albeit rather clumsily.